Hi everybody, this is Crystal. Today I'm going to show you how to make this baby dress. It probably fits sizes 0 to 6 months, and this is the only size that I have available at the moment. In addition to the yarn that I mentioned, you're also going to need a hook and eye closure to hook up the back, one or two of these that you need to sew on with a regular thread and needle. And you're going to need some ribbon roses too if you decide to put them on. That's completely up to you. But let's go ahead and get started on this. Okay, for this project, I am using Red Heart Fashion Soft, which is a lightweight number 3 100% acrylic yarn. It's really soft. It's nice. There are 381 yards per skein. And the color I am using is artichoke, and I'm also using another one, cream, which I'm going to be using for the edging. So one skein will be enough to make the dress, and then you'll need another one for some edging on it. And I want to give a special thanks to my friends at Red Heart for supplying today's yarn. I'll put a link below where you can purchase this yarn if you want to use this for this dress. Also, I encourage you to check out redheart.com, where they have all kinds of free patterns for you to enjoy. And then I'm going to be using a size H, which is a 5mm crochet hook. And you want to start off with a chain of 56. And once you get your chain of 56, what we're going to do is we're going to put one double crochet in the fourth stitch from the hook. And remember, we never count the one that's on our hook. So one, two, three, in the fourth one, we're going to put a double crochet. Just like that. And now I'm going to put one double crochet in every single stitch for the length of the chain. So just like that, all the way to the end of the chain. And when you get to the end, you should have a total of 54 stitches, and that is counting this little guy here on the end. This little chain thing here, he counts as a stitch. So 54 when you get to the end, counting this little guy. Okay, when you make it to the end of the row and you count it and you have your 54 stitches and counting this little chain here on the end, what you want to do is chain one and turn your work. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put one double crochet right back here in the very, very first stitch, the same stitch. Like that. And now I'm going to put one double crochet into the next stitch. So there's two double crochets we did in a row. Now the next stitch is going to get two double crochets in the same stitch. So there's one, I'm going to go back in it and put another, just like that. And now I'm going to put one double crochet in the next two stitches again. So you have two in a row again. So there's one and two. And then the next stitch, I'm going to put two double crochets into the same stitch. And that's our increase stitch. Like that. Again, one double crochet in the next two stitches. So there's one and one in the next, and then the next one is going to be two double crochets in the same stitch. So we're just going to repeat this pattern until we get to the end of the row. One double crochet, one double crochet, two double crochets. One double, one double, two. One double, two. All the way to the end. And when you get to the end, you should have a total of 72 stitches. Okay, I'm coming to the end of the row. And I just did my two double crochets in a row. And then I'm going to end it right here in this little chain thing. It's going to have two double crochets into that last stitch. So your last stitch is this chain thing. And it should have two double crochets in it. Just right in the top of it. Oops, I didn't get it. try that again. So right here into the top of it. There we go. So there's one and two. And then we're going to chain one and turn. And remember, you should have 72 stitches at the end of that row. And now we're going to start the row three. And we're going to put one double crochet right back into that same stitch. Like that. And now I'm going to put one double crochet in the next two stitches. So there's one and two. So counting that first double crochet, now we have three double crochets in a row. And now the next stitch is going to get two double crochets into the same stitch. So that's going to be our increase stitch. And now I'm going to put one double crochet in each of the next three stitches. So there's one. Here's two and three, and then the next stitch is going to get two double crochets into the same stitch. So there's one and two, and I'm just going to kind of repeat that pattern to the end of the row. So one double crochet in each of the next three stitches. There's one, two, and three, and then two double crochets into the next. Just like that. One double crochet in each of the next three stitches. So one double, one double, one double, and then two doubles into the next. One double into each of the next three, and two doubles to the next. All the way to the end of the row. And when you get to the end of the row, you should have a total of 90 stitches at the end of row three. Okay, once you make it to the end and you counted and you have 90 stitches, you should have ended with two double crochets in that last stitch. What you want to do is chain one and turn, and we'll start row four by putting one double crochet right back here into that same stitch. And then we're going to put one double crochet in each of the next three stitches. So there's one, two, and three. So counting that first double crochet, we have four double crochets in a row. And now we're going to put two double crochets into the next stitch. Like that. And now we're going to put one double crochet in each of the next four stitches. So there's one, two, three, and four, and then two double crochets into the next. So that is the repeat for round four. One double crochet in each of the next four stitches. So there's one, two, three, and four, and then two double crochets into the next. So you just want to repeat that pattern until you get to the end of the row. One double crochet into the next four, and then two double crochets into the next. Repeat that to the end of the row, and when you get to the end of the row, you should have 108 stitches at the end of row four. Okay, once you make it to the end of your row, you should have ended in two double crochets again in the same stitch there and have 108 stitches. Now we're going to connect our piece. So what we're going to do is just going to take it and we're going to come over here. And we're going to slip stitch into the first stitch of row four. Just like that. Now our piece is connected. And now I'm going to start saying rounds instead of rows, since we'll be going in rounds. So now I'm going to chain one, and I'm going to turn my work, because we still want to work in the back and forth rows. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put one double crochet right here in this very first stitch. So right there. Like that. And I'm going to put one double crochet into the next four stitches. So there's one, two, three, and four. So counting that first double crochet that we did, we have five double crochets. And now I'm going to put two double crochets into the next. So there's one and two. And now I'm going to put one double crochet in each of the next five stitches. So there's one, two, three, four, and five. And then two double crochets into the next. And that is going to be the repeat this time around. One double crochet in the next five. There's one, two, three, four, and five. And then two double crochets into the next. So you just want to repeat that pattern all the way around, back to the beginning. Okay, once you make it to the end, your last stitch should have two double crochets in it. And what we're going to do is go ahead and slip stitch into the first double crochet. Not that chain one we did. That chain one does not count as anything. The first double crochet. Like that. And now we're going to chain one and turn our work again. And you should have had 126 stitches at the end of that round five. Now we're going to start the armholes. And what we're going to do is we're going to put one double crochet into the first 18 stitches. So right here, this first stitch, I'm going to put one double crochet in it. And I want to have 18 double crochets in a row. So that was one, this is two, three, four, five, six. Okay, there's 18 double crochets I did. Now what I'm going to do is chain four. One, two, three, four. And now I'm going to skip 26 stitches. So I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. Skip them. And in the next one, I'm going to double crochet with that chain four on my hook still. Just like that. So that is our first armhole. So there's 26 stitches there and a chain four. Now I want to go ahead and do a double crochet into the next 38 stitches, counting this one as our first one. So there's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay, once you got your 38 double crochets done, you're gonna chain four again. One, two, three, four. And again, we're gonna skip the next 26 stitches. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, and then the next one with that chain 4 still on your hook, double crochet. Oops. Do that again. Like that. Now you should, counting this one, have 18 stitches left. And what you want to do is go ahead and double crochet in those remaining stitches. So remember, counting this one, you should have a total of 18 till you get to the end of the row. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, once you make it back around, you want to go ahead and end with the slip stitch to that first double crochet. And now you should have a total of 74 stitches. That's not counting these sleeves. We'll work with them later. That's these 18 here, the 18 here, and the 38 in the front. And then you'll have your two chain 4 spaces. Now what you want to do is chain 1 in turn. You want to make sure the right side of your work is facing you now. Like the back is open, this is the right side. If it's not, you want to make sure that it is. And now, turn my camera down a little bit. We'll start row 7 by, we're going to double crochet. We're going to do a V-stitch right here into this next stitch. So we're going to double crochet into it. And then we're going to chain 3. And then we're going to go back into it and do another double crochet. So that's how we're going to be making our V-stitches. A double crochet, a chain 3, and a double crochet. Now I'm going to skip one stitch. And I'm going to V-stitch into the next. So I'm going to double crochet, chain 3, go back in it and double crochet again. Like that. I'm going to skip one and do a V into the next. So I'm going to double crochet, chain 3, and double crochet. Like that. And by putting them this close together, it should make the link, make it more gathered in the dress, more roughly looking. So I'm going to skip one and V-stitch into the next. That way it gives the dress a little bit of body and it's not so flat. Like that. Skip one and V-stitch in the next. And we're just going to repeat this until we get to our first chain 4 space. So I'm going to finish these out and I'll meet you right here at this chain 4 space. Okay, when you make it to your first chain 4 space, all I'm going to do is work 2 V-stitches through the space. So I'm going to, when I came to this end here, I had 1 stitch left. You skip it and then I'm going to work. There's 1 V-stitch. And then I'm going to do another one. 1, 2, 3, and like that. Oh, dropped that one, didn't I? Try that again. Like that. So now you got 2 V stitches in there, kind of push them together like that. Now I'm going to start again with my first stitch, making a V stitch in it. And skipping the next stitch, working a V-stitch into the next, skip in the next, and then the V-stitch into the next, and I'm going to repeat this again across the front here until I get to my next chain 4 space. Like that. Skip, V-stitch. Skip, V-stitch into the next. Just like that. So go ahead and repeat that across the front of your dress until you get your next chain 2 space. Or chain 4 space, I'm sorry. Okay, when you make it to your next chain 4 space, again, you'll have this one stitch here that you skip. And just go ahead and put 2 V-stitches through the chain 4 space. And there's one. And 2. And you can kind of make them the right shape. I guess it doesn't really matter. But then we start right here again in the first stitch with a V-stitch. And then we skip one, and then we V-stitch in the next. And we're just going to repeat this same pattern until we get to the end of the round. Skip one, V-stitch into the next. Just like that, until we get back over here to the beginning. Okay, once you make it back to the end, you should have 41 V-stitches right now, counting all of them, including the 2 that we did on each sleeve. And now we're going to slip stitch into the top of our first double crochet of our first V-stitch. We're not going to turn our work anymore now. No more turning. Like that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to slip stitch right over here to the first chain 3 space. And now I'm going to chain 1. And I am going to work 5 double crochets through this space. So it's going to be a shell. I'm going to work a shell. It's going to be 5 double crochets. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Like that. And now what I'm going to do is jump to the next one and work a shell again. 5 double crochets. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Again, I'm going to jump to the next one and work 5 double crochets into the chain space. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And I'm going to work 5 double crochets or a shell in every single one of these chain 3 spaces or the middle of the V-stitch all the way around. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then again the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that's what it kind of starts to look like. So I'm going to go ahead and put my shell or my 5 double crochets in every one of these 41 V-stitches. Remember when you get to this arm space here, where we did the 2, kind of push the V-stitches together so you can see the spaces. But I'm going to go ahead and do that. And when I get back around to the beginning, I should have 41 shells. Okay, when you make it back around, what you want to do is slip stitch into your first double crochet right here. Not that chain 1, but the first double crochet. Like that. And now we're kind of just going to be repeating those 2 rows. What we're going to do is slip stitch over 2 times until you get to the middle stitch of the shell. So, one, two, and that brings me into the middle. That's what you want. Now I'm going to chain one, and I'm going to do my V-stitch right back into that same spot. So I'm going to double crochet, chain three, and double crochet again, like that. And then I'm going to skip these four stitches and V-stitch into the next, which is actually the middle stitch of the next shell. V-stitch, double crochet, chain three, and double crochet, like that. And again, I'm going to skip four stitches, so you'll be skip, 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 skip. And in the next one, which is the middle stitch of the next shell, V-stitch again. And that's the repeat this time around. It's really easy. Skip four and V-stitch into the next stitch, which is the middle of the next shell. And I'm just going to repeat this all the way around. And that's what it kind of starts to look like. And when you get back around, you still should be having your 40, 41 V stitches. Skip four and V stitch into the next. Just like that. So I'm going to repeat this all the way back around to the beginning. Okay, when you make it back around, again, we're just going to slip stitch into our first double crochet, and it's just we're going to be repeating those two rows. So we're going to slip stitch over into the chain three space, chain one, and then we're going to shell stitch, or the five double crochets, right here into this space. So there's one, two, three, four, five, and then jump to the next space and shell stitch again. And I'm going to do that all the way around. So it's just a repeat of the V stitch row and the shell stitch row. So it's pretty easy. I apologize if I get out of camera. I'm looking straight into the camera and I can't see what I'm doing when I do that because the camera's right in front of me. So in order for me to see when I'm crocheting, I have to look over the top of the camera. And then I tend to pull it up in front of it. I don't mean to do that. I'm sorry. I don't know why. I just can't look into the camera and see what I'm doing. I have to look over the camera. And then it tends to pull up. And I never mean to do that. Like that. And that's what it starts to look like. So I'm just going to keep repeating the rows of V-stitches and the shell stitches. Just back and forth, until I get the length that I want my dress to be. Okay, you want to work for a total of, from the top down, 19 rounds. So starting with number 1, count all the way down to number 19. And 19 should be a V-stitch row. So after that, I just went ahead and ended my row like normal. I slip stitched into my first double crochet and then I tied off. And now I'm going to switch colors to my edging color. So I'm going to go ahead and start my yarn right here in this, where I left off, in this chain three space. And I'm going to do a shell with a picot on it in this space. So I'm going to chain one. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to work three double crochets all into this space. So there's one, two, three. Now I'm going to put a picot on this one. So I'm going to chain three and I'm going to come right back down. I always go slip stitch right into the side of this right there and then the side of this stitch. Slip stitch that, and that's going to put a little point on the top of it like that. And then I'm going to go back into the same chain space and do two more double crochet. So what I did was the shell, but I put a picot in the middle one. So it's five double crochets all together, but there's a picot on the third one. So now what I'm going to do is single crochet right here in between the space of the B stitches. So just like right through here, I'm just going to put one single crochet. Now I'm going to jump over to the next chain three space in the next V stitch here, and I'm going to do the shell picot again. So I'm going to do three double crochets. There's one, two, three, and I'm going to chain three, and then some people for a picot, they'll slip stitch into the very first chain. I like to go down and slip stitch kind of in the side of the stitch like that. I think it holds it better. But you can do it, and if you learned it a different way, that's fine. Like that. And then go ahead and do two more doubles. And that'll make a total of five doubles for our shell with the picot. And then I'm going to go right in between the next two V's right here and single crochet. So this is the pattern. I'm going to cut that tail that I'm going to repeat all the way around. So the next one is going to be a shell with the picot right in the V stitch or in the chain three space. So I'm going to do three doubles. And then I'm going to do a picot on this one. One, two, three. I come back down and I grab the side stitch and then this side stitch like that. And slip stitch. And I'm going to go ahead and do two more doubles to finish that off. Just like that. And now I'm going to go ahead and single crochet right here in between the two V stitches. Like that. Shell picot in the next V stitch. One, two, three, chain three, come back down, slip stitch. Two more doubles, two, and then I'm going to go and single crochet. And you just want to repeat that same pattern all the way around. And then when you get back around here to the beginning, which I already went around, I just did my last shell picot, and I want to go ahead and single crochet right between these last two V's. Like that, and then I'm going to slip stitch here in my first double crochet, not the chain one, but the first double, and I'm going to tie that off, clip my yarn, and hide my tails, which I'll do that in a little bit. Now we're going to work on the sleeves, which I already have one of them done, and they're really easy. So I'm going to go back to my green yarn that I was using. Oh, I slung my hook across it. Okay, I'll show you how we're going to start here. Okay, we're going to start our yarn. Now, both sleeves are going to be made the same way. Okay, pull your sleeve up. Like, here is the little crease area where we did the chain four. We're going to start. And here's our stitches. We're going to start right here in the side of this double crochet. Right there. So I'm just going to go right through that whole space and start my yarn. And I'm going to chain one. And then I'm going to go right back into that same place, same space, and put one double crochet. And now I'm going to put a double crochet right here into this next space. And then I'm going to do a double. Now right here is the chain four. And remember, we put two V-stitches in there. So you want to get your V-stitches kind of put together. There's one of them. And there's the other. I'm going to do my next double crochet right here. Here's where I did my last one. I'm going to do my next one right here beside this V-stitch. It's actually kind of upside down now. Like right there. And I'm going to do my next one between these two V-stitches. So here's one. Here's the other. I'm going to go right here in between them. And then I'm going to do my next one on the other side of this one. So you can pull it over. So it's going to go right there. And then I'm going to put one double crochet right here in this next space. And then one right here into the side of this double crochet that's on the other side. Just like that. And now I'm just going to work across. You'll be able to see the stitches better now. Putting one double crochet in every stitch all the way around. Until you get back around to your first double crochet. And remember, both sleeves are done the same, so I'm just going to show you how to do this one. Go ahead and work one double crochet in every stitch around the sleeve here until you get back over here to where we started. And you should have a total of 35 stitches when you make it back around. Okay, I've made it all the way around. I'm on my first round of the sleeve. And like I said, you should have 35 stitches, and I do. So now I'm going to go ahead and slip stitch into my first double crochet, like that. And now we're going to do a row of decreases. So I'm going to chain one, and I'm going to put one double crochet right back there into the same stitch. And I want to work three double crochets in a row, and then I'm going to do a double crochet decrease. So this is number one, so I'm going to put a double crochet in the next stitch, that'll be two, and then a double crochet into the next stitch, that'll be three in a row. And now I'm going to do a double crochet decrease, and that has worked over two stitches. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to yarn over, go into the next stitch and drop a loop, and yarn over and go through the first two loops on my hook. Then I'm going to yarn over and go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over and go through the first two loops on my hook, and then I'm going to yarn over and go through all three loops. So that took two stitches and made it into one. Now I'm going to put one double crochet in each of the next three stitches. So there's one, two, three, and then I'm going to do a double crochet decrease over the next two. So I'm going to yarn over, go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over, go through the first two, yarn over, go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over and go through the first two, and then yarn over and go through all three. One double crochet in the next three stitches. So there's one, two, three, and then I'm going to do a double crochet decrease again. I'm gonna yarn over, go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over, go through the first two, yarn over, go into the next stitch, drop a loop, yarn over, go through the first two, and then yarn over and go through all three. So I'm just going to repeat that pattern all the way around back to the beginning. Okay, once you make it all the way around, you should have ended in a decrease, and you should have a total of 28 stitches. And now you want to slip stitch into your first double crochet, like that. And now we're going to do decreasing again. So we're going to chain one, and we're going to put one double crochet right back into that same stitch, like that. And now we're going to do five double crochets in a row, and then we'll do a double crochet decrease. So that counts as one. There's two, three, four, and there's five, And then we're going to do a double crochet decrease over the next two. Just like that. And again, five double crochets in a row. One, two, three, four, five, and then a double crochet decrease. And this is the pattern we're going to repeat this time around until we get back to the beginning. Okay, when you make it back around, you should have ended in a decrease again, and you should have 24 stitches. Now we're going to slip stitch into our first double crochet. And now I'm going to tie this off and clip my yarn. I'm going to switch colors here. Let's start with my edging color again. I'm just going to start right there in that same stitch that I ended in. I'm going to chain one. I'm going to go right back into that same stitch, and I'm going to do a double crochet. Or I'm going to do a single crochet. I'm sorry. Now I'm going to do a single crochet in the next stitch. And now I'm going to do a picot on this stitch. So I'm going to chain three and then go back down and go right through it like that and slip stitch like that. Now I'm going to do a single crochet in the next. And then I'm going to do a single crochet into the next. And a picot on this one. So chain three, go right back down and slip stitch that, single crochet into the next, single crochet into the next, and picot on this one, chain three, go right back down and slip stitch, single crochet into the next, single crochet into the next, and picot on this one. And this is the pattern I'm going to repeat all the way around. Single crochet, single crochet, and picot on this single crochet. So what you're doing is just, it's just a picot on every other stitch. And you want to do that all the way around to get back to the end. Okay, when you make it all the way around, your last stitch should have been a picot. And then you're just going to go ahead and slip stitch over here into your first single crochet. And then you should have a total of 12 of the picots around the sleeve. And I'm going to tie this off and hide my tail. And then remember, you do both sleeves the exact same. And then we'll go ahead and get started on the neck area. Okay, with the your work facing you like this, the back side, we're going to work from here. And we're going to work around like this. So go ahead and grab your piece. And right here, this kind of first chain thing we did, that's going to be our first stitch. So what we're going to do is chain one, and we're going to go right back into it and double crochet. Now what we want to do is two double crochets in a row and then a double crochet increase. So this counts as our first one. We're going to put one double crochet into the next stitch. So it's two in a row. And then the next one is going to get two double crochets in the same stitch. Now we're working kind of backwards like this. So when the collar flips over, it'll be right side up. And then one double crochet in the next two stitches. So that's one and two. And then two double crochets into the next. So there's one and two. And we're going to repeat that all the way around the whole collar until we get back over here to the other side. It's kind of awkward, I guess, but one double crochet in the next two stitches. So one, two, and then two double crochets into the next. One double crochet into the next two. There's one, two, and two double crochets into the next. So I'm just going to repeat that all the way along here, the whole collar, till I get back over to here. And when I get back over to there, I should have 72 stitches. Okay, when you make it all the way here to the end, your last stitch should have two double crochets in it. And it's probably going to be this little knot here, very beginning stitch. It's going to be kind of tight. Kind of go right into that, and it should get two double crochets into it. Like that. And now I'm going to chain one, and I'm going to turn my work. So I'm going to start working the other way. And now what I'm going to do is put one double crochet right back into that same stitch. And now I'm going to work three double crochets in a row. So that counts as one. Here's two. And then three. And then I'm going to do an increase. Two double crochets in the next stitch. One. Two. So three double crochets in a row. Here's one, two, three, and then two double crochets into the next stitch. There's one, two, three double crochets in a row. There's one, two, three, and then two double crochets into the next. And you want to repeat that all the way around until you get to back to the other side. Okay, when you make it down here to the other side, to where you have four stitches left, see, I just put two double crochets in that stitch, and I'm going to go ahead and put one double crochet into the last four stitches. I'm not going to put two double crochets in that last stitch, which would actually finish out the repeat. I'm just going to put one like that. And now you should have a total of 89 stitches at the end of that row. And now I'm going to chain one and turn my work. Now I'm going to do some picots. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to skip this very first stitch, and I'm going to single crochet into the next and picot on it. Chain three, go back in, and like that. And I'm going to single crochet into the next. Single crochet into the next and picot in this one. So I'm gonna chain three, go back down and do my picot like that. Single crochet into the next, single crochet into the next, and picot. This is just the same thing that we did along the edge of the sleeves. Single crochet into the next, single crochet into the next, and then picot. Single crochet into the next, single crochet into the next, and picot. So it's the same thing we did on the sleeves, and I'm just going to repeat this along this collar here. Like that until I get over here to the other side. Okay, when you make it to the end here, I just did my last picot and I have one stitch left here. I'm just going to go ahead and slip stitch into that last stitch, and then I'm going to tie this off, and you should have 44 picots now across the collar. And I'm going to tie this off, and now we're done with the crocheting part. I'm going to hide all my tails, and then we're going to sew on some roses, and you got to sew on the hook and clasp on the back. Okay, once you get all your tails sewed in, You want to take this hook and clasp closure, and you just use a matching thread and a needle and sew it right up here. That's what I'm going to do. If you want to use a couple of them, you can. I'm probably just going to use one. And also, if you didn't have one of these, you could probably even use a button, I would imagine, and button it over here. But you just sew that on right back here. And then, if you want, this is optional, you can put ribbon roses on it, which I'm going to do. You could put them across the front if you want. However many you want. You could put one, three, however many if you want. Sew them on. Or you could actually use a low heat hot glue gun and hot glue them on, because that works really well with yarn. They probably will never come off if you hot glue them. I'm not going to say never, because if you have it on a baby, you still have to be careful with these roses. But otherwise, you could use the matching thread and sew them on real tight too, if you decide to use them. So I'm going to go ahead and get that stuff done real quick. Okay, once you get your ribbon roses sewed on, if you decided to use them, and your closure on the back, that's it. That's all there is to it. I hope you enjoyed my tutorial. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and check me out on Facebook, Etsy, Instagram, Pinterest, Twitter. I'll put links to all that stuff below in the description box. And please don't forget to check out redheart.com, where you can find all kinds of free patterns. And until next time, have a good day.